On Friday evening, shortly after midnight, so technically on Saturday morning if you want to be pedantic, I clumsily clicked on my Hargreaves Lansdown app because it is located next to the Twitter app on my phone's home screen. Since I have facial recognition turned on for my login, it logged me straight into my account before I had time to return to the home screen, open up Twitter, read someone saying something terrible, and then go to bed all angry with how awful people are. Where there is normally a little blue plus sign though on my account with some blue numbers and a blue plus percentage in the top left corner of my account, there was just red. Lots of red. And above all of that red, where Hargreaves Lansdown tell you your total portfolio value, my account had lost something like 40 to 45% of its value in a single day. In a moment of panic, I wondered whether I'd missed the news of a global financial crisis akin to the Wall Street crash of the early 1920s. Perhaps China had invaded India, or maybe Putin had launched a nuke heading straight for New York. Given that Prince Philip had just died, it is quite possible that the BBC wouldn't find time to mention any of those events. A quick Google search revealed that the markets hadn't yet collapsed, and a nuclear apocalypse wasn't yet upon us. Hurrah! I may have lost half of my investments, but at least I wasn't about to be scorched to death or plagued by radiation poisoning. The next stop was Twitter, to find out what on earth was going on. But lo and behold, no one had tweeted anything about or to Hargreaves Lansdown. It seemed that it was just me who had lost all their money. This was at 3 minutes past midnight. As it turned out, the problem had only occurred at 12, hence why I was apparently the first person to spot it. I refreshed Twitter a few times, and then the complaints came rolling in, with people declaring that they were having heart attacks, they could no longer retire as they had planned, and they were going to have to learn how to code. As it turned out, it was just a glitch. My initial panic subsided fairly quickly when I discovered that the shares in my portfolio that had declined by around 98% were all overseas stocks, and it seemed to be a problem relating to the exchange rate putting the decimal point in the wrong place. There was a moment where I thought maybe the markets really had crashed, in which case I would be buying plenty of Alphabet stock at 23p a share, among others. Alas, that wasn't the case. It was just a software error which had been rectified by the morning. So, why am I even making this video? Well, for a start, no one else on YouTube or even in the wider press seems to have covered it, and I found it quite interesting for a couple of reasons. Firstly, I think it is quite bad on Hargreaves Lansdown's part. They charge extortionately high fees in comparison to a lot of newer, sexier trading platforms and brokerage apps that anyone can download on their phone, precisely because they're supposed to be reliable, consistent, and don't suffer from these types of panic-inducing blunders. Or at least, that is what I felt was supposed to be their USP. If not, then what? Why would anyone endure the high charges? I suppose the other factor would be customer service. Certainly that was one of the reasons that drew me to HL as a beginner with little idea what I was doing just a few years ago. I was pretty surprised then to discover that they do not operate a 24-hour phone line. This is a FTSE 100 company who turned over £550 million last year and pride themselves on their easy-to-reach, friendly customer service. And yet, their phone lines are only open from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Monday to Friday, from 9:30 to 12:30 on a Saturday, and not at all on a Sunday. Doesn't that seem a bit, I don't know, bad? For people who couldn't understand why their portfolios reported such steep losses, who logged into their accounts during that time, they had no way of contacting someone who could explain what had happened or put them at ease. If that had happened on a Saturday evening and not been rectified, someone might not be able to get any answers until the following Monday morning. So yeah, I don't think that looks great for Hargreaves Lansdown, given that is supposed to be their sort of area of expertise and their advantage over cheaper alternatives. I'm not saying that I'm going to suddenly close my account or anything, those are just my thoughts. There is a wider point about what people thought when they opened their accounts and saw those huge losses. People who saw those losses thinking that they were real and thought their lives were ruined, they probably shouldn't be investing. You should never invest money that you may need in the short term. The logical position, if there was such a ridiculous short, sharp decline, is to look to buy really solid companies whose share prices have been harpooned for no good reason. And that is a lesson for investors to always keep some money on the sidelines ready for a downturn, particularly following such a lengthy bull run. So, those are my musings on Hargreaves Lansdown's glitch, both in terms of the company and a slightly broader point about investor temperament. Make no mistake, my stomach sank for a moment, but the logical position is to see a downturn of that kind as an opportunity. Well, I mean, if there was a 98% downturn to all stocks, then maybe not. That probably does mean that the world is about to implode, but a 40, 50, even 60% decline, you get the idea. That is to be expected, and you certainly shouldn't be investing in individual stocks if you're not aware of the potential that at some point you could lose half of your investment. Today's video was just a short one because I'm working on something slightly different and longer for next Monday, so keep an eye out for that and subscribe to the channel if you don't already. And my apologies for the lack of an upload over the bank holiday weekend, bank holiday here in the UK at least, but I didn't get any of those 4 days off due to my day job unfortunately. Thank you all as ever for watching. Please do hit the like button if you enjoyed today's video. Let me know your thoughts as always down below in the comments, and make sure that you are subscribed and have notifications turned on for the one and only The Reluctant Investor.